you're leaving school and you've decided that you think you want to become an electrician. And that all sounds great in your own mind. However, it's not just about thinking about being an electrician when you leave school. You've also got to do what, Ben?
Do some work experience to know that you like what you're actually going to do rather than just going into the job and not doing it.
Absolutely. Ben's been working with me for about 6 months now. He's only 15 years old. You're still at school, aren't you? Okay. Yeah. And he said to his mum, I think I want to be an electrician. And then she came to me. She cuts my hair every 4 weeks. So we've spent some time over the last little while working together. And I think the first thing I said to you was, you know, you want to be something. There's a big difference between wanting to be something and actually being something. So you took your first work experience with Marcus, didn't you?
Yeah, we did some practical work and had a look at how to like, do lights and stuff like that.
Gave you a golden opportunity then, even before you've left school, to think, if this is really, really, really what I want to do, the first thing I always suggest to everyone is do some work experience. I know it can be difficult, especially if you're 15 years old, you have to cash in some friends and family to do that. That's really important. Now, it could be that you want to be an electrician and you're struggling to get some work experience. Okay. What other things have you added to your CV that suggests when I interview someone that you actually want to be an electrician?
Doing some certificates to let them know that you're actually willing to learn and willing to do what you've said you want to do.
Yeah, so when you say certificates, Ben means the ones that we've got on the eFIXX Apprentice Hub. Yep. So we've got the know-how tab. You can either find it by directly on the know-how tab or you can find it through the eFIXX Apprentice Hub. And in there is some certificates that take, how long does it take roughly to get?
Half an hour.
Yeah, half an hour to an hour, maybe maximum an hour, to get a certificate. You can print that certificate off and all of a sudden your CV, which currently looks awful, doesn't it? Yeah. Okay, you emailed it again to me last night. It's very generic. It's a vanilla two pages, isn't it? It says, I work hard and I'm dedicated and all those lovely buzzwords. Doesn't scream of I want to be an electrician. As we develop your CV through to hopefully when you do eventually either start a college course or you get an apprenticeship, what things does your CV really need to focus on if you want to be an electrician?
It's focus on the stuff about being an electrician, not other stuff like everyday life, like what you do in your spare time.
Yeah, no one's interested in lots of ways if you like Minecraft. A little dig there, I doubt he likes Minecraft. But Ben, it's all about, you know, I want to be an electrician. So those additional certificates anyone can get, put them on the CV, can't they? And you're up to how many now?
13.
13, because I set you, you only had two, didn't you? On the CV you sent me last night, you only got two on there. Yeah. You've now got 13. There was a reward for that, wasn't there? You're going to get some tools off me for getting to 13. So all of a sudden now I'm thinking, when you sit in front of me, maybe you've got to do a year at college, you never know. So you're sitting in front of me and you say, I want to be an electrician. You're going to show me the work experience you did when you were at school. You're going to show me a minimum of 13 certificates that are electrically biased.
Yeah.
Am I now as keen about looking at your GCSEs or is it more electrically focused?
More electrically focused because it shows you've gone out of your way to do the electrical stuff.
Yeah, and maths and English, what are you going to get GCSE wise?
5 in the maths and the I think it was a 5 in English as well.
And you need both. You need them above 4s in your maths and English in order to do an apprenticeship. It's part of the standards, okay? It used to be a framework and it's part of the standards. So, of course, it's vitally important that you get those as well. But just think about that CV is what I say to everybody. And does it ooze, I want to be an electrician? Other things that can suggest that you want to be electricians is following people on YouTube, isn't it?
Yeah.
So you can follow all those electrically biased channels on YouTube. Start watching what an electrician does in the day. If you can't get out and do any work experience, you've got those certificates. Do you do much electrical work at school? Is there anything in there? Plug tops or anything like that? No, it's just physics and things like that. So again, it is difficult, isn't it, to say, yes, when I leave school, I want to be an electrician. So top tips for me, get some work experience, get some additional certificates on there and have photographs on your CV. Yeah. What sort of photographs are you going to add to yours?
Photographs of you and photographs of work you've done so it show that what you're capable of and what you've already tried to do.
Yeah, I'm a great believer in the two-page one they want you to make at school and college isn't enough. We love pictures now, we all love videos and things like that. Let's have a load of pictures on there that suggest you want to be an electrician. Maybe it's your college work. If you're at college, pictures of the jobs you're doing at college. You're not at college yet, you're obviously looking for that job, so it's pictures of you doing your work experience. But that can become overpowering. It can be too many pictures and you could be a bit concerned. Can you remember what I asked you to set up to store your pictures?
An Instagram account to follow and to follow certain people so that certain people see it.
Yeah. So I said to set up a private Instagram, so as in away from your you and your
friends
mates.
And stuff.
Acting silly. Away from your friends and just do it as an electrical trainee. Because then you can post all your photographs on there, but also you can start following local electricians and national electricians. You can start asking questions and hopefully you can use that to get yourself some more work experience and or job.
Yeah.
Do you think you want to be an electrician?
Yeah.
And what did you do today? What were we up to?
We done some light fittings and changing lights for someone that was doing
So we took these old halogen ones down, they're 50 watts each, and we replaced them with LEDs. First time you ever fitting a light fitting?
Yeah.
How many did you fit today?
Three or four.
Four. I think yeah. I did two, didn't I? Yeah. So yeah, the six that we've replaced. Again, it's great groundwork experience. And if you don't like it, so you got on work experience and you don't like it, what does that mean?
It means that you should just leave, just say that you don't want to do it. You don't have to be forced into what you don't yeah. want to do.
And when we say force is probably a strong word. I always think sometimes it's mum, dad, grown up carer at home that says to you, they wish they'd had a trade when they left yeah. school, and they sort of employ it onto you. Was it your idea or your family's idea? It was your idea. Yeah. Okay, so we're already on a winner. You've already got 13 certificates. You've done some work experience. It's got a right whiff, Ben. And actually, you want to be an electrician. Yeah. So there's some good advice from Ben. We've had a little fun today fitting those LED light fittings. So in recap then, work on your CV, add in pictures, create an Instagram account, do some additional certificates on the eFIXX Apprentice Hub via the know-how tab, and see if you really want to do it. And if you tick all of those boxes, I would suggest, like Ben, you probably want to be an electrician.